Hi everyone, welcome to one more Sunday brunch ideas. I'm going to today show you a few brunch options. You know, Sunday we usually get up late, we don't want to get up so early. It's a weekend and we want to laze around. So here are a few recipes today. I'm going to show you three of them, three options which are you can have it as breakfast, you can have it as a brunch, or and there are going to be two versions of it. There's going to be the low calorie version and there's going to be the normal one, that's for those who are not really have to watch their weight, the lucky ones, and the ones who are keeping a calorie count. I've got something for them too. So here are the ingredients. This is, I have taken two pieces of brown bread, and then we are going to come to the stuffing. So it's going to be made of mushrooms cut very small, spring onions, you've got florets of cauliflower, a little bit of onions, green chilies as per your taste, sliced carrots, and then there is broccoli. For the garnishings or for, you know, adding more zing to your dish, there is capsicum or bell peppers in two colors, one is red, one is yellow. I've got a few ones in green also. These are two carrots that I've kept for garnishing. A few rocket leaves, as you can see. And here are two capsicum, which I have not really cut the base. You see, this is like a top that comes off completely. So if you are looking at the capsicum, here is how you're going to cut it. Keep it whole, like a bowl. Now we move on. This is cheddar cheese. This is egg white. And this is yolk. Yolk which has been taken off from the egg white. I haven't wasted that and I have put two more eggs in it. So this is the normal egg which is whisked. And then I have some red chili flakes, salt, pepper, onion flakes, and this is parsley. And this, then we are going to straight proceed on to our cooking status. Now we are going to proceed on to cooking. So I have taken a pan, and in this I am just going to pour 2 teaspoons of oil. So here is the 2 teaspoons of oil that is going in. If it was me, I was making it for one person, then I would be making it with 1 teaspoon oil. But since this is going to be multiple brunch recipes that I am going to show you, so I have taken the liberty of adding 1 more teaspoon. So the total goes 2 teaspoons into the pan. And now I am going to put in all the ingredients that we had chopped. So the chopped ingredients are as follows, as you can see that I've got them in the kitchen, and we are going to just have them all put in the pan together. But it is advisable that you put the onions, the green chilies and the mushroom first before you go on to something like a cauliflower or a you know, a broccoli or a spring onion. Spring onion should be added at the last. And carrots can be also added when you're adding in the cauliflower. So I'm going to put them all one by one. As you can see, I have put the capsicum, the onions and the green chilies. Remember, do not add too much of green chilies because we have chili flakes and a bit of pepper that will go into your stuffing that I'm going to make. So please be careful with the chilies. You don't want it to be too hot and people burning their tongue and not really liking the Sunday brunch that you're going to offer them. So here it is, the capsicum and the onions and a little bit of green chilies that I've put. They are going to be now sautéed a bit before I put in the rest of the vegetables. Because the mushrooms and the onion have browned up a bit, and you can see I've added the rest of the vegetables. Look how colorful your pan is looking. I really love colors in my food, and you know, that adds real good dash of attractiveness to the dish. Stir it all around, mix it well, and as you are doing that, what you can add is a bit of the onion flakes. So sprinkle the onion flakes a bit. A bit of the salt goes in. Now it depends on how much salt you would like to add to your dish. I would tell you don't add too much because there is salt in the whisked egg also. So that is not going to be good to taste. I have added the spring onions now because the rest of the vegetables have more or less got sorted. And it's always advisable not to cook your vegetables too much. That takes away the nutrient quality. Just a bit so that the raw smell and the rawness of taste goes away. But just keeping it lightly braised and sauteed would serve your purpose, and it would be tasty too. You would enjoy the vegetables in their very crunchy and wholesome flavor. Now you see, I've taken the sorted vegetables off and I put them in a bowl. Look at the color. It's very nice. It's well done, as you can make out. And we are now going to go on to doing the final part of the three brunches. So here, as we move forward, you can see I've put the two bread in one plate. There's an empty plate out there. And I've put the capsicum, the bell peppers, on a separate plate out here. So we are going to move first with the bread. So as we move, we are going to take a bit of the stuffing and we are going to put it on top of the bread. So here I have put the stuffing on top of the bread, and now I'm going to take a bit of the cheese and then put it on top. Depends on how low-cal you want it to be. So I'm not putting much in it, a bit in this. You see, one toast has got more cheese in it, one toast has got less cheese in it. Cheese is up to you, how much you want to put, how much does your calorie count or your diet permit you. So it's completely up to that. So while this is done, we will put this into the micro. And as we put the bread into the micro, we'll move on to the second brunch recipe. So I have put the bread into the micro, the stuffed bread with the cheese. And I'm going to close it. And we are going to put it for not more than 3 minutes. We are going to move on to the second brunch. And here is the whisk dip. And I've added a little bit of pepper and salt in it. And the first dish. You take a dish which is probably has got a little bit of scoop. Hold out dish so that the ends of the dish are a little curved upwards. It will give you a nice lift to the final meal that we are going to prepare. So I'm going to pour in the egg out here. As I've poured in the egg, next comes in the capsicums, the bell peppers. And what else do we put? Oh yes, herein comes the stuffing. So I'll be putting the stuffing inside this. Anything that has fallen inside, you can pick it up and put it in. It's all egg, so it really doesn't matter. This is your second dish that is going on. It looks great after it is cooked, partially because it gives it's very attractive to kids. It gives a different look to your usual omelette. It's not an omelette yet. I'm going to name it later, but before I name it, I want you to see the final outcome of the dish, because that will justify the name that I'm going to give. Simultaneously, you can also pour in one bell pepper the rest of the egg. Now don't pour fully, because after you're going to cook it, it's going to fluff up. So, and the next one, I'll be putting the egg white. Now into this will again go the stuffing. So I'm going to take the stuffing and put it inside the bell peppers, which has got the eggs in it. In the meantime, the toast has been done, and this is how it looks. And while this has been done, I'm going to put the second one. So I'm going to put the omelette inside the micro. Now here, a bit of the cheese goes in, but it's not going to go in now. So here it is. And as we are going to again put it, now this time it's going to be for 5 more minutes. Now comes our third branch. So here I've put the stuffed vegetable, I've put the egg white in it. This is the healthier version. And here I've just put the vegetable and I'm going to pour the egg, the yolk and the normal egg into it. This is going to be that bowl which is going to be for those ones who do not have to watch their weight. So here it goes in. Need a little bit of careful pouring here. Now for the toast that has been made, we are going to sprinkle a little bit of the parsley. Bit of the parsley goes in, a pinch as you can see. Now this red chili flake is purely for color and a bit of the taste if you are up to it. And this is your toast which is ready. Now look at the omelette. You see it is hardening up. The insides are a little soft, but it's more or less coming up. And this is an omelette without oil. I want you to note that. Now that it is half done, what we can do is now we add a bit of the cheese in this on top. And we must stop the micro at a point and add the cheese. It's stuffed with the cheese and I'm closing the micro and it's going to go on. I'm going to increase a bit because I see the inside is a bit soft. So 3 more minutes perhaps. Now you can see the omelette is done. I've taken it out of the micro. The cheese has nicely melted. And there is the whole thing. Now I'm going to let it cool a bit because there's a little more part to it that has to be done. But before that, I'm going to let this cool a bit. In the meantime, I can again, this is again as per your taste, we can add a bit of the chili flakes in this and we can add a bit of the parsley in this and keep it for cooling down. In the meantime, while I'm getting these dishes ready, I'm going to put the stuffed capsicum into the microwave and we are going to microwave it for about 5 more minutes. So let's see what happens now. To the omelette, I've added a few rocket leaves. These are very nice to taste and they should be added raw after the cooking. And I have just plugged it in inside the cheesy part. So hoping that it will get stuck while the omelette cools down. While the capsicum is getting cooked, now what we will do is we'll take a knife and we just make it go around the omelette a bit so that, you see, this has been cooked without oil. So there will be a tendency of the egg omelette to stick to the pan, but that really doesn't matter. Once you have used a knife intelligently enough, it now comes off and yes, now it's easy to lift off also. Now this is a dish that that looks like a pizza and I'm going to call it an egg pizza. You can give it any other name that you want, but I think this is something very attractive for kids. And you've got vegetables in it, you've got the egg in it, the cheese in it. So I think that's going to be quite an attractive option for any kid or any teenager. The capsicums have been microwaved. This is the one where there is no cheese, it's the egg white one. And this is the one with the yolk where I have added cheese after 3 minutes of the stuffing, you know, inside the bell pepper getting cooked. After 3 minutes of that, I've just added the cheese and put it for 1 more minute. And herein, I'm again going to use a dash of the parsley. And here again, I'm going to put a bit of the parsley here. So parsley goes into the next dish a bit. Yes, a handful of red chili flakes just to add something to it. And you can see that I have garnished it also with a carrot. And I've put 2 rocket leaves just to make it attractive. The egg white has poured itself out. Really doesn't matter. It's all going to be one fine dish. And here the egg yolks with the cheese and the stuffing is ready. Now we are going to see the final 3 recipes all together. This is finally the 3 brunches. And the sandwiches, the stuffed sandwiches that you can see, the stuffed capsicums, and here is your egizza, and you are set. And the garnishing is done also, so it looks very attractive. I completely believe that, you know, the dish should look attractive. Today's youngsters and even us adults, we really don't want to try something new, or we really don't want to eat something which really looks shabby on the plate. Something that looks good, tastes good, has a real great value. So here are the three recipes for you to try out on a Sunday. Hope you've enjoyed all the three recipes that I've shown you. I hope you will try them all out also. These are low calorie options, and these are interesting ones also. So try them out for your Sunday brunches and your Sunday breakfast, and let me know. I would like to know your feedback. Thanks for watching my show, and please carry on to like my videos and subscribe to them and share them with your friends. Thank you.